to be part of the Super Bowl if it is. But I don't think so. In my opinion, Vordor can be as exciting as happiness, sadness, and anger. Yes, exciting. And yes, I'm still talking about Vordor. In an interview with J.R.R. Tolkien made by the BBC News and its program team in 1968, he said that one day he was dreading his Harvard student semester tests when he came across a blank page which his student forgot to fill in. He studied the blank page several moments, not knowing what to do with it, when he immediately scrambled down those words on the blank page. In Holding the Ground, Derelict the Hobbit. And that is how one of the most classic novels ever created were made. Here we can see that by the role of Borden, one of the most creative pieces of art were created by a teacher's turn at a blank page. Now we all go through different emotional states. Happiness is satisfaction, sadness is some factor of happiness, and anger is some frustration feelings towards something triggering. And then there is boredom. What is boredom? A lot of people try to define it throughout the years, but no one really came about and combined all the definitions into one big thing we can all agree upon. The simplest definition I could think of is that boredom is simply the lack of interest and the situations where the brain has no stimulations. Now, what is a stimulation? Where really a stimulation is just an activity which keeps our brain busy. And you know what? Those stimulations are very, very hard to find. The brain is required to be incredibly creative in order to find those stimulations, and it will always seek for them. Our brain is always looking for those stimulations, no matter how hard it will work and how creative it needs to be in order to find them. For example, when I was a little kid and I was very, very bored and I had no stimulations because I was just staring out of my house's living room, I was starting to think about how adults are so concerned with charging their phones. I said, how can we make this entire concept of charging something more enjoyable? I tried to figure out what happiness is, and I figured out it's some kind of a chemical in your brain called dopamine. I said, well, how can we make our phones be charged by this dopamine? How can I make this whole concept of charging more enjoyable for those phone owners? I made up an entire plan about how to actually charge your phones by being happy. And it does not matter it was absurd, and it also does not matter it was impossible. It matters that I was thinking, and it matters that I was being creative. It mainly matters that I was very, very bored to begin with. So let's go back a minute. I've said that boredom are the situations where we have no stimulations. I've already said, and I've also said, that when we are bored, we need to be very creative. So does that mean that boredom actually leads to this creativity? And more than that, does that mean that if we would never get bored, we would never be creative? Well, believe it or not, but it's partly true. There were big long-term neurologic researches in the ANA, which actually proved that when we're not bored, yes, we are actually being creative, but much less, and in almost at the zero level. When we are bored, the researchers said that we're actually very, very creative, much more when we are not bored. You know what else does that mean? It probably means that if we would never get bored, much, much less would never be creative. Because think about that. Imagine if our ancestors had iPhones or any kind of smartphone 200,000 years ago. Every time they would get bored, they would probably check Facebook or Snapchat or any kind of social media, or they would play some game on the phone. And that's exactly what we do today. Today as a society, we cannot tolerate boredom. Every time we get bored, we already check our phones. And that means that probably much as we'd never be created, because every time we are creative, then it leads us to think, and thinking always leads to some kind of idea. So fortunately, our ancestors did not have iPhones, but we do. As 4.93 billion people in the world have an iPhone, more than half of the world population. Next year, in 2019, it is supposed to grow up to 5.07 billion people having an iPhone. or any kind of smartphone. I think this is a catastrophe because what do you do nowadays when you get bored? You already put up something to keep you busy. As a society, we cannot tolerate boredom anymore. 3 seconds being bored and we already cannot stand it. So I want you to just stop listening to me, please, and just start listening for 15 entire seconds. I will stop you when I finish counting. Please stop now.
One.
This is around 15 minutes, 15 seconds as I counted. I can probably say that most of you might have felt your fingers itching. Some of you might have felt like this was just a waste of those 15 seconds of your time and your life. Some of you might have felt like you're sick and nauseous, but I guarantee you, if you looked every day for 15 minutes, not 15 seconds, you would do something big. Because thinking big leads to doing something big. And remember what I just said. Remember that boredom is not actually your biggest enemy. Boredom is actually your biggest ally. Boredom is responsible for all the tip-top conditions you live in. Because without this boredom, probably the car, clothing, and anything you have today, and anything which differentiates you from what we were 200,000 years ago, is all thanks for boredom. And remember, as John Kabat-Zinn said, when you pay attention to boredom, it gets unbelievably interesting. Thank you.